Hi. Welcome back. My name is Dakota Bradshaw, and today is episode 2 of the reading of William Shakespeare's Star Wars by Ian Doescher. Today we will be continuing the story in Act 2. Scene 1, inside the Lars homestead. Alas, C-3PO, alas, my R2-D2, he hath flown, and all the while he beepeth on and on about his duty in rebellion's cause. Oh, with what strength shall I be punished when R2's treachery discovered is? So shall I hide myself behind this ship in hopes I'll not be found by Master Luke. C-3PO hides. Enter Luke Skywalker. Luke, C-3PO, I say, what dost thou there? At what game playest thou, O jolly droid? C-3PO emerges. C-3PO, I prithee, sir, be thou not cross with me. 'Twas through no fault of mine, in truth I swear. Pray, let me not deactivated be. I asked him, aye, and urged him not to go. With sighs and words aplenty I plead I him. With many earnest pleadings made my cause, and yet he was to me as one made deaf. His metal ears, as 'twere, did seem to plug, as though no word of mine could penetrate and break upon his sense of hearing. Oh, I fear cursed malfunction doth befall my dear and treasured R2 unit. Luke. Nay, C-3PO. Aye, verily, his mission is supreme, so saith he. He will not be hindered be, nor from his wayward, stubborn purpose ever. Chorus. Now with these words young Luke doth quickly run beyond the shuttered doors, with failing hope and stepping out beneath the setting sun, he scans the vast horizon with his scope. C-3PO. Sir, ever hath that R2 unit been a problem that hath vexed me through and through. Astromech droids have ever puzzled me. Their minds have tempers mighty to behold, though all contained in frames of modest size. Luke. Fay! How have I so easily been tricked? This R2 hath performed his greatest feat, to vanish, scope to wheels, into the air. C-3PO, aside. Now he is angered. Peace, my master, peace. To Luke. Good sir, forgive my impudence, but may we yet this e'en go and a search? Luke. Nay, 'tis far too dangerous. The night is dark, but darker are the dreaded sand people. And darkest most of all their thievery. Thus as darkness waits for light to dawn, so must we wait for the morning to arrive. Owen. Inside. O Luke, come hither. Swiftly come ye in. The time hath come to darken down the power. Luke. Anon. Good uncle. Thy good word I'll heed. To C-3PO. Oh, shall I taste the whips and scorns of my dear uncle's anger? So shall that small droid, though yet far gone, wreak havoc on my soul. C-3PO. Aye, sir. 'Tis true. Although the droid is skilled in laboring and service, most doth he excel at wearying the hearts of men. Luke and C-3PO withdraw for the night. Chorus. And so restless night doth pass within, while Luke doth ponder future punishment, and longs for his lost droid search to begin. C-3PO doth fear his banishment. At early morn with eager wills they rise, a sharp endeavor binding them anew. The fast land speeder o'er desert flies, they go to find the errant droid R2. Luke and C-3PO enter, flying in a land speeder. Luke. Good Luke, take heed. Luke. Good friend, take heed, the scanner doth report a droid ahead. Pray swiftly take us hence, belike our R2 there waits. Aside. Perhaps I'll yet escape my uncle's wrath. Chorus. While droid and man go racing across the sand, the Tusken Raiders watch the two pass by. Their banthas mounting, gaffy sticks at hand, they heave into the air their warring cry. Enter R2-D2. Luke and C-3PO dismount and to speak to R2. Luke. Pray, whither goest thou, thou naughtiest droid? R2-D2. Beep meep, beep squeak. Nay, Master Luke is now the rightful owner. Learn obedience, aye. Learn thou loyalty. Pray, learn respect, and learn thou not to speak of Obi-Wan Kenobi. R2-D2. Weenie, squeak. C-3PO. Speak not to me of mission droid. I'll warrant happy thou shalt be if our new master doth not let thee know the blaster's deadly touch today. Luke. Patience. Pray, dear C-3PO, 'tis well. But let us hence. R2-D2. Beep whistle, knee, meep squeak. Luke. What can the matter be? What doth he say? C-3PO. He doth report that creatures hither come, approaching stealthily from the southeast. Luke. Sand people! Hither, come, and let us see. Aside. Unbidden doth adventure come, yet here I stand prepared to rise and welcome fate. A twisting strand she threads we must but trail, for 'tis the wire that leadeth us through life. Fate's hand hath placed me here on Tatooine, and now she beckons onward through the abyss. Now o'er adventure, great abyss, I perch, above all time, above the universe, above the rim of chance and destiny, and sister fate doth dare me look to in. And thee, aye, there, I find my happiness, I peer therein, embrace my fate and blink. Come life, for I am ready now to live. With scope to droids, I spy two banthas, yet no sand people. Wait, wait, one doth appear unto me now. Chorus. With sudden viciousness the Tusken comes, they knock young Luke and cause the droid to fall. They seek to take the harshly pillaged some, till frightened by a false cryet dragon call. Enter Obi-Wan Kenobi, who has made a cryet dragon call to frighten off the Tusken raiders. Obi-Wan. Now enter I the scene of this boy's life. This boy whom I've watched for many years hath grown into the man before me now. My hope I now entrust to him alone, that he might be our sure deliverance. And yet the situation warrants care. I must approach with caution as we speak, and meet his questions as a trusted guide. My inner joy I must with patience hide, for certain 'tis gives me great delight to see him now, his face, his golden hair. So long have I watched o'er him from afar, so many hours and days of my life spent in hope, expectation of this one. In his beginning I shall find my end, this business shall reveal my final stage. Yet in my closing scenes perhaps I'll write a worthy ending to my mortal days. 'Tis possible that in this gentle one, the dream I've long awaited shall come true. So I'll compose a final act that shall accomplish two most worthy ends, to set the world aright and save this old man's soul. To R2-D2. Well met, my little one. R2-D2, aside. Almost I could my metal tongue release and speak to him. This man doth show sure signs of wisdom and experience. To Obi-Wan. Beep, beep, meep, beep, meep, squeak. Obi-Wan. Come hither, tiny friend. Be not afraid. R2-D2. Beep, squeak, wee-hoo. Obi-Wan. Nay, prithee fret thou not, for he shall make a full recovery. Luke wakes. Rest easy, lad. For thou hast had a fall, and more adventure hast thou seen today than many in a lifetime do, I say. Thou catchest fortune's favor to survive a cruel attack from sand people most vile. Luke. But by this light, 'tis Ben Kenobi here. It fills my heart with joy and soothes my pain to meet thee. Obi-Wan. Aye, 'tis well, but let's go hence. The Jutland Waste are no place for travelers is. Now prithee, good young Luke, say, wherefore thou art here? And what strange errand bringeth thee herein where I am wont to dwell? Luke. Destroyed, I assure thee, he hath brought me here. R2-D2. Beep meep. Luke. It seemeth unto me that he doth search to find his former master. Yet in all my days I ne'er have devotion seen, as this one showeth from a droid. R2-D2.
Who?
Luke. Yet he claims he belongeth to a man named Obi-Wan Kenobi, and I thought perchance the man some relative of yours, maybe-est. Dost thou know any by such name? Obi-Wan aside. Oh, how the heart inside me breaks to hear that name I once was called so long ago. But happy fate is that Luke's voice that calls. To Luke, aye. Obi-Wan Kenobi. Obi-Wan Kenobi aside. Oh, the name is like a song, yet whether glorious song of joy or else some dirge of bitter pain I've yet ensure. To Luke, it is a name I've not heard for lo, these many, many years, a long, long time. Luke, my uncle knoweth Obi-Wan I ken, he doth report to me the man is dead. Obi-Wan aside, oh, Owen, wretched knave, such base deceit, and yet I know full well why thou so spokest. Should I have acted different in thy place? To Luke, but nay, the man takes not his final sleep, at least unto this moment now, not yet. Luke, then knowest thou him? Obi-Wan, aye, verily I do. I know the man as if he were myself, for truly I, he is, this Obi-Wan, dear Luke. Tis I. R2-D2, aside. By heaven's light! To Obi-Wan. Beep meep! Obi-Wan. I've not heard this name, this Obi-Wan, since ere and thou thyself wert born. Luke. Aye then, I see this little droid is bound to thee. Obi-Wan Kenobi. I have no memory of owning such a droid as this. Tis curious indeed. Sound of Tusken Raiders aside. Now mark thee, these my words. We must repair indoors to scape a second cudgeling here. The sand people do easily take flight, but soon they shall return with many more. R2-D2. Beep meep, beep beep, meep squeak. Luke. C-3PO. C-3PO wakes, broken in pieces. C-3PO, where am I? Have I ta'en an ill-timed step? In dreams have I seen visions of my death, 10,000 shoulders pressed upon my grave, and I alone to face the murderous mass. Could only weep at my untimely end. Luke, peace, peace, good droid. Thou art alive, fear not. Canst thou now stand? We quickly must depart before the sand people attack us here, and strive to make thy dream reality. C-3PO, oh, whether dream or waking I know not, but go thee hence and save thyself, I pray. C-3PO, by nightmare hath been slain. Obi-Wan, aside, this droid shall quickly stretch his welcome thin. Luke, I shall not leave thee, droid, thou speakest sans escape. Come, come, I'll bear thee up, so are you not. Obi-Wan, aside, what noble care he takes to soothe this droid. To Luke, we must make haste or face them yet again, so hence let us away into my den. Scene 2. Inside the Kenobi homestead. Enter Obi-Wan Kenobi, Luke Skywalker, C-3PO, and R2-D2. Luke. Nay, thou art misled, O wise one, for my father hath not fought many more wars. Full many evenings as I lay abed, such tales I heard of him I never knew. A navigator on a freighter ship, which carried Fragrant spices hence to yon, my father was. He kneweth not of wars. Obi-Wan. So hath thine uncle told thee. Mary, he did not agree with aught thy father told of his philosophy and brave ideals. Thine uncle, tethered to the land, did not believe thy father should become involved in matters of the stars and empires. Nay. Aside, what shall I of the father tell the child? If gentle Luke knew all that is known to me, I'll warrant he did not understand the rhyme and reason for my words. And yet, what is to lie? To tell the truth, all else be damned. Or else to tell, perhaps, a greater truth. Is it the truth to tell the boy each fact, and thus deface his father's memory? Or have I spoken better truth to Luke, when I about his father speak with pride? Aye, every child deserves a champion. Luke, hast thou done battle in the Clone Wars?
Obi-Wan,
aye, and once I was a Jedi Knight, same as thy dear father. Luke, oh, how tears well up within me for the loss of that dear man, whom I never did I know, nor do, nor will.
Obi-Wan,
I tell thee truly, amongst the pilots he was e'er the greatest in the galaxy. He also was a cunning warrior, and to the last he was a dear, dear friend. Aside. And now, to play upon his natural sense of self-importance, to draw him near to thoughts of Jedi training for himself. To Luke, I hear thou art a pilot skilled as well. This calleth to my mind a gift I have for thee. Thy father hath desired that thou shouldst have this weapon that when thou art of age. Thine uncle, though, would none of it so feared, that he that thou might join with Obi-Wan upon a fool's crusade or devil's task, just as thy father hath when he was young. C-3PO. Dear sir, if thou dost need me not, I shall shut down upon the present moment here.
Obi-Wan aside.
Why speakest he here when 'tis my time to speak? These droids of protocol are uncouth. Of etiquette they know little but troth. Luke, pray tell, what is it?
Obi-Wan.
Of thy father's lightsaber. It is the weapon of a Jedi Knight. If thou in thine own hand could hold a sun, then thou wouldst know the power of this tool. Not merely random, neither awkward like a blaster. Nay, the lightsaber maintains a noble elegance, a Jedi's pride. 'Tis something for a civilized new age.
Chorus.
Now holdeth Luke the weapon in his hand, and with a switch the flame explodes in blue. The noble light Luke's reverence doth command. That instant was a Jedi born anew.
Obi-Wan, aside.
Now doth the Force begin to work in him. To Luke. For many generations, Jedi were the guardians of justice, peace, and good within the Old Republic, ere the dark times came, and ere the Empire gan to reign. Luke, how hath my father died?
Obi-Wan, aside.
Oh, question apt! The story whole I'll not reveal to him, yet may he one day understand my drift. That from certain point of view, it may be said that my answer is the honest truth.
To Luke.
A Jedi named Darth Vader, aye, a lad who I had taught until he evil turned, did help the Empire hunt and then destroy the Jedi.
Aside.
Now the hardest words of all I utter here to this innocent, with hope that one day he shall comprehend.
To Luke,
he hath thy father murdered and betrayed, and now are Jedi nearly all extinct. Young Vader was seduced and taken by the dark side of the Force.
Luke, the Force?
Obi-Wan, the Force. The Force doth give a Jedi all his power, and 'tis a field of energy that doth surround and penetrate and bind all things together here within our galaxy. R2-D2, aside, in hearing this wise man, I have almost my errand quite forgot. Now to my work. To Obi-Wan. Beep, meep, meep, squeak. Beep, wee, squeak, whistle, meep. Obi-Wan. And now, my little friend, shall I attempt to find out whence thou came, and to discern the reason wherefore thou hast left thy home for lands unknown, a mission to pursue? Luke. He hath a message played. Obi-Wan. Thus have I found. Enter Princess Leia, in beam projected by R2-D2. Leia. Dear General Kenobi, many years ago thou servest my noble father in the Clone Wars. Now he beggeth thee to come again and aid him in his struggle with the Empire. Sadly may I not be there with thee in person, my request to give. My ship of late hath fallen under siege, and thus my mission, bringing thee unto my cherished planet Alderaan, hath failed. Yet have I deep within the memory banks of this brave R2 unit stored the plans most vital to them for Rebellion's victory. My father can retrieve the plans therein, but I must ask of thee to take the droid and bring him unto Alderaan with care. The desperate hour is now upon us, please, I beg thee, O sir. Oh, help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi, help. Thou art my only hope. Exit Princess Leia. From beam. Chorus. The message end, then doth the silence fall, while Obi-Wan his duty contemplates. Young Luke considers whether fate doth call. Aye, in this moment destiny awaits. Obi-Wan, aside. The boy doth hear and hath the taste of fire new burning in his ears. Now shall I play the part of fuel and gently stoke that fire. To Luke. Thou must be taught the Force if thou wouldst come away with me and go to Alderaan. Luke. Nay, Alderaan. Aside. This man hath many charms, and now it seems to me that I have been these many hours under some great spell that he hath cast. To Obi-Wan. Nay, I must hence back home. 'Tis late, and Uncle Owen shall be vexed if I do not return to him ere long. Obi-Wan. Aside. And now it must be done, or else 'tis lost. To Luke. I say all thy good help, Luke, so doth she. For such adventures I have grown too old. Luke. Nay, nay, I should not be involved, dear friend. Much work there is to be completed yet. And as the seers say true, a crop without a harvester is like a dewback sands its rider. Verily, I loathe the cruel and noisome empire. I, yet, nothing against it have I power to do at present. Fie. 'Tis also far, far distant from this place. Obi-Wan. Thus speaks thine uncle through thy lips, not there, not thee. Luke, mine uncle, oh, my uncle, how shall I to explain this matter? Tell me how. Obi-Wan. Come now with me, and learn the Force, dear Luke. Luke, aside. Now am I split in twain by fate's sharp turns. Two paths, the one towards adventure leads, and the other takes me back to my home. I have for all my life longed to go hence, and now this Obi-Wan hath reason given why I should leave my Tatooine and fly unto the stars. Aye, he hath told me of the powerful Force, and yet another Force doth pull me home, the Force of duty and responsibility. I would go hence and fly today and ne'er look back again, except Beru and Owen are my true and loyal family. 'Tis settled then. I stay on Tatooine until the time when I may leave with clear and fettered soul. To Obi-Wan. I shall take thee as far as Anchorhead. From there mayest thou find transport to where ere thou goest, aye, throughout the galaxy. Obi-Wan. Thou must hold with thy conscience, it is true.
Whatever thou thinkest right, thus thou shouldest do.
Excellent. Scene 3. Inside the Death Star. Enter Imperial Generals and Senators, including Admiral Mati and Commander Taj. Taj, until this battle station utterly prepared and operational shall be, 'tis plainly vulnerable to an attack. The rebels have more resources and are more dangerous than thou wilt deign to see.
Mati,
perhaps the danger to thy Starfleet eye, but not into this battle station strong.
Taj,
rebellion shall not gain more support within the Imperial Senate. Enter Grand Moff Tarkin and Darth Vader.
Tarkin, aside. Oh, these men do talk and quabble, like a brood of chuckling hens.
To Taj. The Imperial Senate, which thou speakest of here, no longer any threat to us doth hold, for truly, I've just received word that our great Emperor himself dissolved the Council. And now the final remnants of the old Republic fade away like dew.
Taj, but Mary, 'tis impossible. How shall the Emperor maintain control without the Crimson Cord of vast bureaucracy?
Vader, aside. Oh, how these politicians irk me so. Of governors and territories care I not, but I retain their company for mine own purposes. And though their talk doth tire my hand, I do confess that naught I found hath on their counsel yet improved. For every human bond is meaningless, all family doth leave, all friends betray, and lovers fail, and teachers turn, and thus among the politicians shall I dwell. Where lies deceit and garrulous talk do make the universe go round. But yet I vow, I'll not be governed by the governors, no policy of politicians heed. Instead, myself and my dear Emperor together shall pursue our destiny.
Tarkin.
The governors of the regions now have sole control over their especial lands, and fear shall keep the people all in line.
Fear this very battle station, I,
Taj.
But what, pray tell, of the rebellion vile? For if the rebels have the plans to this good station stolen, possible 'tis they may have found a weakness, which in haste they shall exploit.
Pray, Tarkin, mark my words.
Vader.
Those plans shall soon be recovered, fear not.
Mati.
Attack on this station pointless is. Regardless of the data they have found, I speak not rashly when I have aver. This station now hath power ultimate, or all else in the vast wide universe. And now, I prithee, let us see it used.
Vader to Mati.
Nay, peace, I warn thee, man. Be not too proud of thy great terror technological. A weapon for the mass destruction of a planet, even to destroy it whole, is no match for the power of the Force.
Mati. Thou shalt not tempt to frighten us with words so like a man of magic veer.
Nay, thy sorcerer's act is tiered and overdone. The sad religion thou dost cling to hath no power to conjure up the stolen plans, nor dost thou have a third eye sight to make.
Vader begins to choke Mati using the Force.
Of course, the power of the Force is now unveiled, as Vader holds the Admiral in check.
The Force of that Mati is, with his words impaled, now hath Wampa's hold around his neck.
Vader. I find thy lack of faith disturbing.
Tarkin.
Cease! No more of this! Good Vader, let him be.
Vader.
As is thy will.
Aside.
My point hath well been made upon this prideful, unbeloving throat.
Vader releases Mati.
Tarkin. Enough! This endless bickering shall end. Lord Vader shall provide the setting of errant rebel base before the time the station shall be operational. And then, my friends, the Empire shall rejoice. Rebellion shall be crushed in one swift stroke. Now get ye gone. Fulfill this purpose grand.
Exeunt Imperial Generals and Senators, including Admiral Mati and Commander Taj.
Vader, My troops on the planet Tatooine have traced the creatures who have found the droid. We shall receive those plans.
Tarkin.
Tis well, tis well. Thou ever wert faithful servant to the Emperor, Lord Vader. Prithee, go and take with thee a governor's gratitude. Exit Darth Vader.
There goest a man who hath the mind to serve. The Emperor doth hold him in his grasp, yet lays claim on his heart and soul. When I recall, as a younger man, the Emperor and Vader with me stood and contemplated our shared destiny. Now Vader, split twixt manhood and machine, fulfills a vital place within my plans. I, though I fear the Force, he knows his place. He knoweth he and I stand side by side, together wrapped in power, warmth, embrace. Our Emperor to serve until, at last, the final curtain of life's play is dropped. As history hath made this Tarkin great, this battle station now shall make me fear. I am as constant as at the Endor moon, and shall rebellion crush, and to do it soon. Exit Grand Moff Tarkin. Scene 4. The desert planet Tatooine. Enter Obi-Wan Kenobi, Luke Skywalker, C-3PO, and R2-D2, surrounded by Jawa corpses. Luke. It seemeth that the Sand People have done this wretched deed. Yon gaffy sticks and tracks of Bantha eye. But ne'er in all my years have Tuscans gone awry so far as this.
Obi-Wan.
That they have not, though. They would, who this vile deed have done, would make us think Sand People did. But hark, take note, and look ye thereupon. Yon tracks are side by side, yet Sand People, 'tis known, ere one behind the other to ride, so better they may hide their numbers large.
Luke.
These Jawas are the very same who sold C-3PO and R2-2. Unto my mind, uncle, not 2 days ago.
Obi-Wan.
And these marks here, these blaster points, are too fine and accurate for Sand People.
'Tis true, for only stormtroopers by Empire trained are so precise and cunning in their work.
Aside. Surveying this scene, I fear what cometh next. For certain have the troops more evil done. Good Owen and Beru no doubt are slain. And though it breaks my heart to think it, it may be that their deaths will spark Luke's soul and lead him unto good rebellion's cause. So by their death may others yet find life.
Luke.
But why, say why, would these Imperial troops have aught to do with Jawas? Wait, I see, the droids. If they've traced them here, they may have soon discovered whom they sold them to, which, O my soul, would lead them to my home.
Obi-Wan.
Pray, patience, tis far too dangerous.
Luke runs to his land speeder.
Chorus. Now flies Luke off in his land speeder quick, and finds his home engulfed in flames of red. The spies amid the smoke so black and thick, the bodies of his aunt and uncle dead. A sadder, wiser man he cometh back, with noble purpose now his life imbued. By wrongful vision, cowardly attack, the Empire hath Luke's passion quite renewed.
Obi-Wan, 'twas nothing thou
couldst have done. Had thou been there, thou murdered would have been as well. Aye, also would the droids now be captured, and would be in the Empire's evil hands.
Luke, thou knowest, friend,
what I have seen today. No sorrow like to this have I e'er known. I wish to come with thee to Alderaan. For nothing I have here on Tatooine. Then shall I learn the Force and become a Jedi like my father. Thus I vow. So let's prepare and go upon our way. With haste may we escape the troopers vile.
Exeunt Obi-Wan, C-3PO, and R2-D2.
Adventures have I asked for in this life, and now have I too much to desire? My soul within me weeps, my mind it runs unto 1,000,000 varied paths. My Uncle Owen and Aunt Beru, have they been cruelly killed for what I want? So shall I never want again, if in the wanting all I love shall be destroyed. O fie, thou knave adventure, evil trick of boyhood's mind, that ever should one seek to have adventure when one hath a home, a family so kind and full of love. Good, steady work and vast, abundant crops. Why would one give up all this gentle life? For that one beastly word, adventure, fie. But soft, my soul, be patient and be wise. The sands of time ne'er turned backwards yet, and forward marches fate, not the reverse. So while I cannot wish for them to live, I can my life commit unto their peace. Thus shall I undertake to do them proud, and take whatever adventure comes my way. 'Tis now my burden, so I'll wear it well, and to the great rebellion give my life. A Jedi shall I be, in all things brave, and thus shall they be honored in their grave. Exit Luke. End of Act 2. This has been Act 2 of William Shakespeare's Star Wars, Verily a New Hope, by Ian Doescher. Thank you.